Hi guys, as you can see, I'm in the car. I just got back from probably the first time I've left the house to go somewhere other than work and school in weeks. I have just been on my mid-semester break, which for me means I have to go away to school to do my labs. So I don't really get a break. It gets busier for me this time of year. And then as soon as I got back, I had a full day's work. And then I had a report due last night. So today's Wednesday. I stayed up right up until it was due. It was due at midnight and I got it in with 7 minutes to spare, which I don't usually like leaving assignments that late, but it's been a hectic couple of weeks. But I got it in. I'm not expecting an amazing result, but it's better than a zero. This morning I dropped my son off at school and I just had a break. I decided that I wanted to get out of the house and just not think about study or any of that for a little while. So I went up to my local shopping plaza. I checked my PO box. It was empty. And I did a little Kmart shopping. I went into Big W and the reject shop and Aldi, but there was nothing really that I was interested in. So I got a few things from Kmart though, so definitely gonna share. I did intend to vlog while I was at the shop, but I just didn't. I don't know, I kind of get there and it just all intentions fly away. So I'm really tired. Bub kept me up all night, so I didn't get to sleep. I was still lying awake at 1 a.m. so yeah, and then she just cried all night. She spent half the night in bed with us. I tried to put her back and she just screamed, so just ended up with her in the bed. And then my son wakes up pretty early and that was it. So I am pretty shattered, as you can tell by like my super dark circles. I'm not wearing any makeup today, so rocking the panda eyes. I don't really care at this point, honestly. I have also rearranged my living room, so that's something I wanted to share with you guys. We got a new TV, so I was able to rearrange my living room how I want it. Like, the decor isn't 100% how I want it, mainly because we have little children and you can't have anything breakable within reach, so everything is sort of up really high. And it's not painted yet, so, but it's getting there.
Okay, hopefully you can see me okay. Can I just say, it is the 10th of October today and it's 30 degrees. It is hot. Oh, we have got a horrible summer coming. I can feel it. I've got the ceiling fans going on high and it's still really hot. Not looking forward to it. Okay, I'm just gonna pull things randomly out of the pile. So first of all, I got a stick. No, this I'm going to try and sort of cut up and like have sticking out of that little pot that's on top of my piano and try and make like a faux plant. All the other like little plants will come with pots and I don't want to buy a plant and then not have a like have two pots still. Doesn't make any sense. So we'll see. It might look like crap. That was only $3. I have a bunch of cushions. So first of all is the fringe, like the cream fringe cushion that I've been looking for probably months. When I first saw it come out, I saw it all over Instagram. It's like, I want that. It's $9 and it's this like awesome fringe. I just love it. It's a little fringe cushion and I really wanted it for my bedroom. You know, anything sort of fringe just sort of feels soft and like bedroomy to me. So I've been looking for that every time I've gone into Kmart for months and they never had it. And today my local had a shelf. Finally. Next, I picked up two of the basic cushions. These were $4 each. Crazy, because we needed a couple of just some more cushions out here in the living room. Hubby and I are always fighting over the cushions we have. So these are, they're like a really, really dark navy. They're not quite black, but as you can see, like a darker navy than our sofa. So two of those, $4 each. Really happy with that. Next, I got one of the new Christmas cushions. It says Merry Bright Shine Sparkle and I got this one mainly because it's light gray, so it matches like a couple of the other cushions we have, and the dark writing matches these nice dark cushions. Just looked really nice. The back has this like silver, kind of reminds me of like a cheetah print. I'm not a big fan of that, but I do like this side. They had a heap of cute Christmas cushions. They had like sequin ones, but yeah, I can just see them going yucky after like a short amount of time because I have kids and things just don't get looked after. Next, I bought this rack. It's like a coat hook rack. It's just natural wood, like pegs, five pegs. It's a decent size. This was really inexpensive. I think this was only $8 or $9 as well. I don't have the receipt, so I'm not exactly sure, but it was really inexpensive. It comes with two hooks on the back. Maximum safe load 1 kilo per hook, so 5 kilos overall. That's pretty good. So I'm thinking, actually I'll show you at the end where I'm thinking of putting this. Mainly I got this because we don't have a mantelpiece or like anything that we can actually hang Christmas stockings off. So I thought this would be really good. There's 5 hooks, there's 4 of us, so this would be really good for our Christmas stockings hanging up on the wall somewhere. And then throughout the year we can just use it for other things. So I have to double check with the husband before I hang it, but hopefully he agrees with me. This one was $4. $4. How good is that? It's a Merry Christmas cutout. It's wood. It's really thick. It's solid. I can't believe this is $4. I don't know how you even get the wood for that. The tree is silver glitter. I mean, it does shed a little bit. How can you complain for that price? This, I got one very similar. I don't know whether I still have it or whether I threw it away, because it's the Merry Christmas, but it's bright red glitter and it broke last year. So it's definitely not, so I either put it away broken and will be throwing it away when it comes out. I don't know why I would have done that, but, or it got thrown away. So that's not getting used this year, obviously. And the color scheme is a bit bright for what my aesthetic is now. I'm really enjoying like the natural wood. Last year I did lots of whites and sort of champagne golds and I absolutely loved it, adored it. Natural wood and sort of like burlap and basket weave, like wicker, really liking that sort of aesthetic. So couldn't go past that. Then more Christmas stuff. I love Christmas, in case you haven't guessed. I got a set of the trees. They're the two Christmas trees for $10, so they're sort of flat with the notches cut in them, so you like fit them together so they stand upright. I'm going to put them together after I've done doing this and show you where I'm thinking about putting them. $10 for two, and they're really nice natural sort of wood. One's lighter, one's darker. Really that sort of aesthetic that I'm looking for. Kmart are really doing well with their Christmas stuff this year. I really like it all. Pair of thongs. Live in Australia, you need these things. And mine currently are, well, this is the one I'm currently like, that's it. So I needed some new ones. They're $1.50, they're really cheap. Then I got these. Now I don't usually buy shoes from Kmart apart from thongs because they're crap. I need decent arch support. And they're always really uncomfortable, but these were $8 and I tried them on and they're actually really comfortable. They're like that like Birkenstock style sandal where like the sole is all molded and it has an arch built in, and it's actually really comfortable. So and only $8, and nice pink color, really comfortable casual sandal, so but why not. Then a dress. It's just a cotton summer dress. It might be synthetic actually. Yeah, it's viscose, but it's that sort of like really light, breezy material. This was marked down. That's the only reason I got it. $9 it was, because that's pretty much what I live in all summer. It gets really hot here where I live and I hate like, oh, you can't wear jeans or trousers or anything like that. No way. Okay, little hat, little miss, little sun hat. Cute. It was $4.50. She's got one, but it's a little big, so 6 to 12 months, so this fits her a little bit better. So cute. So little baby hats. Last, I have some cool costumes. Halloween's coming, so I did go looking for some costumes for my son. He hasn't decided what he wants to be, but I got him a couple of things that I thought he would like. He's into these. So they had heaps of really cool costumes for really inexpensive. I was looking online at Mr. Toys and they were $50. And I'm sure they're probably better quality, but $50 for a kid's costume that they're going to wear for a year, that is just crazy to me. So these were $12 or $9 each. I think this one was $12, the other one was $9. So this is a shark onesie. How cool is that? Oh, that's so funny. He loves sharks. So that's 4 to 6 years, so he's 4 now, so hopefully that'll fit him for a little while. It's cute. And then I got a construction worker. Loves Bob the Builder, loves excavators, construction equipment. So it comes with a little helmet and the high-vis vest. I thought that was so cute. So he's got a couple of options for Halloween. And while I was there, I had to get something for little miss. So, little pumpkin outfit. How cute is that? I had little ghosts as well, but I thought the little pumpkin was adorable. And that's 6 to 18 months, so she may be able to fit that next year again. I'm thinking, because it's just the orange part, so the hood and the pumpkin part, so the black stuff isn't included, so it might just be a bit short on her next year, but it's pretty cute. Okay, that's everything. I'm going to go assemble some of these things and try out where I want to place them and show you. Okay, so I have to try and do this without showing you my kitchen because it's absolutely disgusting, if I'm honest. I've got I had an assignment due midnight last night, so I literally have crap. My entire study materials, my laptop and textbooks and everything spread across the kitchen island counter because my back was killing me. My sacroiliac joint is playing up, so I couldn't actually sit down. I had to spend 3 days writing my report standing up the kitchen bench, so that was fun. But anyway, I'm going to show you the living room. Okay, I've got my little vase and my sprig here and a pair of scissors. And I was going to use some styrofoam in the base of this, but that just got thrown away, of course, right when I need it. But I thought, I've got one of those I've got a ton of these because I use them for work, but they're less than a dollar off AliExpress. So I thought that would fit in really nicely. It fits in perfectly in there, and that would work pretty well in place of florist foam or styrofoam. So I'm going to give it a go. With how that turned out. I think that looks really good. Worked really well, actually. Doesn't look super fake. I like it. Okay, so I have the cushions out. That's an old one I had from last year. Don't look how dirty my sofas are either. Now I'm thinking about putting a shelf, with a coat rack rather, up on this wall. I don't know. I think it'll look nice there. What do you think?
I don't think they look quite right, but I'm not really sure where else they can go for now. I think what I'd actually love to do is get one of
the little mini Christmas trees you can get from Bunnings and have that there, like a live one. I think that would look really nice, but I don't have time to run to Bunnings. Oh my god, my hair. Don't have time to run to Bunnings at the moment. So I was hassling hubby for one last year and he would not let me buy one. So I don't know. I think I'm going to have to up the ante this year. It's Friday the 19th. I think it's been a week since I actually last vlogged, but oh well, I'm continuing it on because it was
be too short otherwise. So I just went for a massage, remedial massage, because my lower back has been really playing up. I've been really struggling to even move, bend at all. So I thought hopefully that would help. And it feels really good actually. But while I was here, I checked my PO box and my Foxy Fix is here, but the box says Wanderlust Butterscotch. And I ordered a sugar sour apple. So I'm really hoping that's wrong. So I'm just gonna open it up right now
and give it a check, because look, Wanderlust Butterscotch. That's not what I ordered. I really hope the box is wrong. Okay, so Lush lapis sample. I'm just not a fan of Lush, it's just too soft for me. Okay, let's have a look. Oh, thank God, it's green. That's right. Okay, I'm not going to open any further in the car because it will just make a mess, but phew, okay, that's a relief. So I replaced that candle with this rose gold sort of tea light holder thing. I think just because it was white on white, it looked odd. And that looks better, I think, but it's still not, it's not perfect. But we have a little foxtail potty thing up here now too, so yeah. I think it's gonna need a whole new rethink eventually. And then I got a lamp, it's just from Bunnings. And while we're doing a totally random vlog, I went to Bunnings the other night and picked up this cocoa steak. This is for my monstera that lives in the bathroom that's like sprawling everywhere. The ones in the store had these in them and they looked really nice, so I thought I'd pick one up and some twine and see how I can go fixing it, making it a bit more upright. So this is what it looks like now. I had to move it up on the shelf because it was getting eaten by my daughter. So it's very sprawly. I mean, it's happy, it's healthy, it's shooting out new leaves everywhere, but it's just starting to spread a bit too far. So I'm gonna try and upright it a bit. So this is what we ended up with, and it's definitely a lot more upright. It has since shot out some new ones, which hoping will kind of stay pretty upright. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with it, so hopefully it'll continue to grow up that stake a bit more. I don't know what the deal is with this leaf. It's been like this pretty much ever since we got it. It just sort of, half of it died, but the other half is fine, so it's keeping on keeping on, so I'm not going to pull it off or anything. Looks a bit crappy down here, but I didn't want to be too tight and like jam everything together. Because they're, I don't know, there's a lot going on. They're all sort of the one length at the moment, so they're all sort of coming together, but hopefully that will change as it grows. But it's tolerating it well, it's pretty happy, so. Violet, no, don't eat the plants. So my parlor palm, as you can see, is looking a little sad. I'm not sure why. It's just looking very dry and crispy, I think just because it got hot really quickly. I think it might have a bit of heat shock, but I've been watering it a lot and I put it in the bathroom. It was in my front room, but I put it in here because they tend to get more light and it's just a bit more humid. My monstera was dying and I put it in here and it's happy now, so I was hoping that would work for this one. But I don't know, still got a few good leaves in there. I've been watering it like every few days, just a little bit here and there, trying to keep it happy, but looks like I'm losing the battle, so I'm hoping these dead leaves will just die away and leave these healthy ones. Gosh, I'm being attacked. But we'll see. I mean, I don't like when my green babies are sick. The 20th of November today, so this is like the longest vlog ever. It's like, what, a month, over a month old. But whatever, I'm just running it all together. It doesn't matter, you guys don't care. So I went to edit this vlog and I realized that I never actually did my like living room tour like show you what I have done to rearrange it. I was talking about it and I'm sure I filmed it, but I cannot find the clip anywhere. I'm like 100% sure that I filmed it, but I can't find the clip. So I'm going to show you now. Also added some extra decorations for Christmas now. Not finished yet, and I bought a couple of other things, so I'll show you those as I go. Okay, so this is my living room layout now. So if you've seen my past vlogs, you would have seen that my piano used to go there, and I used to have all my decor sort of on top of the piano there, and then that coffee table used to be where the piano is now, and I had my TV sitting on top of it. So we've got the new TV. I've got fireplace. I know that's like completely back to front, like fireplace and then like mantelpiece for it. But we have wall mounted that now, so that that's new anyway, but we wall mounted it as soon as we got it, so you know, for safety and everything. And that's the reason we bought a new TV, because our old TV was not able to be wall mounted, and we have this running around, you know, as you can see, not safe. So we bought the new one. It's a little bit bigger, which is nice, and we got it for a really good deal, so it's properly wall mounted now. So, and that's why it kind of looks like it's on the piss, on an angle. Don't mind my Australian slang. On an angle, because it's out on the bracket a bit, so that whoever's sitting on that sofa can see it better. So yeah, so we were able to move my piano here, which means we could push this sofa back a little bit, so we didn't have to leave as much room here for people to get through into that part of the house. And also because that now the piano is a lot slimmer than that was, that could now be moved into the middle of the room, and we have a coffee table. So I'm really, really happy with that. So as you can see, we didn't end up putting that shelf up there. We put it on the back of the door, and I think it fits really nicely there. And then I found these at Kmart too. I didn't realize they had these little baskets, and these are specifically made for a hook rack. So they've just got the one loop on, and they just hang there as storage, so you can put like your keys and little bits and pieces in there when you're not hanging coats on them. And we live in Queensland, so let's face it, we're not going to be hanging coats on here very often. And I've just put a couple of little plushies for Christmas in there. That's a little Scentsy buddy clip to spruce up the place, make it feel a bit more Christmassy, because hubby still hasn't got the Christmas decorations down yet. That little guy was from Coles. It's just like a little wooden tag with a like hessian string. I really like that. The cushions are mostly the same, but I picked up a couple of the basic cushions in the lighter gray as well, so I've got two of those in addition to the dark ones. And I just have my wool rug down there. Don't mind like the mess. The kids have had cookies this morning and there's crumbs everywhere. I vacuumed yesterday, believe it or not. So some baby wipes in that little basket there. And then there's my piano. It's looking a bit cluttered, I think. I may have to find somewhere else to put that garland next year. I think it might be a bit much. It's pretty and festive. I thought about around the top of the TV, but then I don't want it to block any of the TV. So I have my big tree down there and my smaller one is up there, in case you can't see. That just has toys in it, but I'm actually thinking about that basket. If we do get a real tree, putting it in that basket, I think that's quite cute. It would only be a really short tree if we got a real one, but I think we've decided that's what we're going to do. So this garland I got from Aldi, it was $25, which is insanely cheap. I don't know how. I'm so glad I managed to grab it, and it was the last one, and it wasn't on the correct shelf, which I think is the only reason it was there. I saw one like this, very similar, in Spotlight last year, but it was just the green. None of the decorations included in it. It was $50 just for the greenery. So I like snatched this baby up immediately. So that's where I have my little Merry Christmas sign. We have my Scentsy Warmer, my Let It Snow Christmas one burning. I've got Hugging a Mug in there. So that's, it's like a coffee scent, but it's got a little bit of chocolate and hazelnut in it as well. It smells amazing. I love it. And this is all just normal. I do have twinkle lights in here, but I need to change the battery out. That looks really pretty at night too, especially around Christmas time. Just my decanters like normal. And then my little tree here. This might stay. I might put it away because it's a lot of green, but I probably don't need any more green around here. This I usually have a little Christmas scape inside. And I actually wouldn't mind. I've been thinking about building a little model, like a little winter scene, like a diorama style, like a proper little model. So, but I have to get the stuff, and I don't really know where any hobby shops are. So I don't know. That may not happen this year, but I'd like to try and do it. And then just my remote controls, obviously, living there. I would like to be able to keep those in that basket. That's kind of why the basket there, but Yeah, that will just get massacred by this little one. Oh, it's all right, sweetie. You're sookie at the moment for some reason. And yeah, my fig isn't looking its best, but that's because I have turned it around. We went away for the weekend and super dusty. When I got back, it had like bent itself really far over to like seeking the sun. So I've turned it around to try and get it to bend back. And when the bug goes for a nap, I sort of drag it out and move it closer to the light, so to give it a bit more direct sunlight, but it still hasn't bent back. So we'll see. I'll give it a bit of a dust and see if that helps. So I'm going to end here. I hope you enjoyed watching this really random vlog. I'll vlog a little bit more probably when we do the proper decorations, if we do more. I don't know how much more we're going to do, honestly, because this little tyrant destroys everything, tears down everything. So yeah, but I'll do a little bit. I still need to get all the decorations out of the attic, so I'd like to say I do Vlogmas, but I just don't think there's going to be enough interesting stuff happening to do that. That'd be really boring for you guys. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed watching this. I will see you next time. Bye, guys.